Welcome to Elite Wine TV. I'm your host, Mark Fusco, here for another episode of the show. So, second episode back from the hiatus. So, here we got today a Texas wine. Bought a year ago. This is the, you know, I don't know how they pronounce it, but we're going to pronounce it like Texans pronounce it. The Llano Estacado. Llano Estacado 2006 Signature Red. They call it the Texas Table Wine. Now, this is a blend of several varietals. You have Cabernet Sauvignon, Merlot, Cabernet Franc, and Sangiovese. Now, if you go to the website, they talk about how in 2005, their blend was actually a Meritage, but they ended up adding the Sangiovese, which is not traditionally part of the Meritage group of grapes. So, they went ahead and removed the Meritage from the label name. $9.99 at HEB, local Texas grocery store. So we're going to check that out. I plan to do some more Texas wines. I'm hoping to actually, every month or so, go visit various Texas wineries, maybe get an interview or two with the winemakers or the owners, and taste some good wine. All right, so a blend of various wines, and one of the names, oh, by the way, it's actually Llano in Spanish, so if you're wondering why I was saying it was pronounced like a Texan, they may pronounce it Llano instead of Llano or Llano. Anyway, so we are going to check it out. A nice little blend here, I like that. All right, so right off the bat, I'm getting a little bit of earthiness, a little bit of dust type of thing. Got some fruit. It's kind of light compared to some other red wines. I'm going to guess that even though Cabernet Sauvignon is the majority of it, on their website it tells you the percentage is 63.2% Cab, 22.5% Merlot, 7.2% Cabernet Franc, and 7% Sangiovese. But it seems a little light. Just red fruits in general, maybe a bit of cherry in there. Some raspberry, almost like that sugary, that candified type of aroma to it, bouquet to it. All right, but I'm not getting too much else. Again, I've really been out of practice for a while, so it's almost like I'm starting over again. Let's go and taste it. Good, but I'm still getting that kind of candified type of like hard candy, and it's not a sweet flavor, it's more of a sensation. Definitely minerality. I know it's aged in oak, they said it's aged for 14 months in oak barrels. But it's not overpowering. You know, you get a hint of vanilla, but it's not overpowering. I'm really getting more of the mineral, almost leather type of flavor to it. Earthiness. So that's where your minerality is. So it seems like the wood is not used to really impart a lot of flavors to it, more to just kind of add a little bit. It's not meant to like overpower it. Whereas not that the Sacre Bleu was overpowering, but you tasted the effects of the oak a little bit more. This, I don't really taste the effects of oak too much. At least not the vanilla type of spiciness, Christmas spices and vanilla. I don't taste that. It's got a bit of wood flavor to it. I kind of understand. It has that bit of wood flavor to it. I'm not head over heels in love with it. I don't hate it. I feel it definitely needs to be paired with food. It's not a drinking wine. It's not a wine that I would want to kind of kick back and drink during an evening. I want to pair it with some cheeses. I want the tannins, and that's what I'm getting, the tannins. I mean, it's not overpowering tannins, but I need something to kind of break the wine down a little bit. I need some cheese, more of a cheese and dairy type of thing. I mean, you put it with steak, put it in with any type of beef, but I need something to complement the wine, and I think it would be better. I'm gonna give it an 87. I think it's a good wine. Again, I'm not over. I'm not like in love with it. I don't hate it, and it's not a meh. It's not one of those meh wines. I mean, I like it, but I wish I was eating something with it. And I think it would be much better. And that's why an 87. So I'm giving it a high 80 score, because I think if you had some food to pair with it, it would really shine a little more. That's gonna do it on the wine. I'm hoping to keep these wine reviews short again. Granted, the last one was pretty long. I was kind of going over some stuff and talking about a couple wines there. Texas, I mean, this is the Llano Winery is in West Texas, and it's in the High Plains AVA of Texas. If you don't know where that is, which probably a lot of people don't know, it's actually in the western part, kind of the western part of area, well, kind of northwest, where Lubbock is. This is the winery is right in the Lubbock area, Lubbock, Texas area. That's where that Texas Tech school is. They got some gun thing. I don't know. Talk about hook 'em horns. But they're in the Lubbock area, and quite a few other wineries are out there. So I'm hoping to check them out at some point in time. Actually, go out to the Lubbock area and say hi to all these guys. Like I said, I like the wine. I would say if you're gonna pair it with some good cheeses, you're gonna barbecue with it, or put steak on the grill, I'd say buy it. It's $9.99. It's very reasonably priced, especially for Texas wines. It's definitely as good as you're gonna find for $9.99 from anywhere else in the country, I think. When you start getting out of California, Oregon, and Washington, you start getting to these states that produce less wine. You start seeing I've seen Texas wines that are about this quality. They're selling for $15. This doesn't sell for $15. At least it didn't a year ago. So I'd say buy it. That's going to be it, and we'll see everybody again next time.